Hello and welcome to our weekly Commodities Corner, brought to you by Safe Sona, a simple, safe, secure way to own gold. First, a look at the headlines. Morgan Stanley Global Strategy Outlook 2020 projects demand weakness for major commodities. Indian coffee exports heading for the second straight year of downturn. And after a brief disruption, it's business as usual with Indian refiners once again contracting Malaysian palm oil. Too much of everything. That is the central message coming out from the recently released Morgan Stanley 2020 Global Strategy Outlook. The report underlines subdued demand for most of the major commodities in the global market, leading to a fall in prices. The weakness in global trade and manufacturing is yet to turn around. As long as this prevails, we anticipate a degree of demand weakness across the board, analysts Martin Ratz and Susan Bates said in the report. In broader pricing terms, the benchmark oil has been averaged at $60 a barrel next year, and natural gas is expected to sustain the current prices. A marginal fall of 1.5% has been projected in steel output, with price forecast at $79 per ton in 2020. Among base metals, copper, however, is expected to do well with 7% price rise. As for the precious yellow metal, the strategists see it trading in $1,500 an ounce range through 2020. Indian coffee exports are heading for the second straight year of decline following low output due to poor weather. According to Ramesh Raja, President Coffee Exporters Association, prices have come down by 10% in the global market in the last 1 year due to oversupply from Brazil and Vietnam. And production drop in India is turning out to be a case of double whammy for Indian coffee exporters. Between January to early October, the Indian coffee shipment stood at around 2,90,000 tons. But with a subdued supply scenario in October-December quarter, it is unlikely to get close to 3,50,000 tons registered in 2018 calendar year.
Adverse weather conditions leading to a little drop in production. These two factors combine and you're obviously getting a lower crop. Less coffee to export, the export has to come down. We think the production is down from about 2% from last year. So generally the trend has been downwards here. Actually, we were expecting much better crops. If you go back 4 or 5 years, India was projecting a big increase in numbers, but actual crops have been coming in lower and lower. So we think the crop will be down by about 2-3% again over last year's numbers. Last year also was affected because of the weather conditions. Last year itself was down.
After a brief disruption in contracting Malaysian palm oil by Indian importers, the situation is getting back to normal. Fearing some hard decisions from the Indian government after Malaysia questioned its Kashmir policy, importers had put on hold their contracting plans from one of their biggest palm oil sources. The Solvent Extractors Association of India too had issued an advisory to its members last month, asking them to be cautious in the future dealings with Malaysian exporters. However, given that the political row is now mostly contained, the futures contracts have resumed, and according to a news agency report, about 70,000 tons of palm oil has been contracted for December. Some Malaysian palm oil exporters are also aggressively playing on prices, offering a $5 discount per ton to woo back Indian buyers.
You know, that somebody must have given up. In the open market, I don't think so that's a discount. Somebody may have offered because of the heavy stock at his end. But that was the one news. You cannot make that news for us applicable to all the purchases here. When last month we issued, that is, we are expecting the government may take some policy decisions and a crossfire, unnecessarily they will be in trouble. We had advised, keep standing away till you have full clarity about the government decisions. Government of India has not taken any action so far. So people have slowly resumed the import of the Malaysia. We have never said a stop it or a boycott. We said, be little careful. It was a cautious note. Be little careful for buying from the Malaysia when there was a heated exchange between India and Malaysia to the highest level.
With that, we have come to the end of this presentation. A special thanks to our sponsor, Safe Sona, simple, safe, secure way to own gold. Do visit our website www.indoasiancommodities.com, watch our videos on YouTube, and follow us on Twitter and LinkedIn for regular updates from the exciting world of commodities.